The reason why I am here is not because I did this. The reason why I am here is because of the ripples that sailed me till here. I showed this video not because I wanted to show that, yes, I can do it. It's actually everyone can do it. You just have to go home and pick up two brushes and just do it. Just focus and you can do it. Anyone can do it. Let me share some honest journey that I have been through and few experiences from which you might relate to. When I was a kid, I thought I would be something painting on the wall or something. I thought I would be an astronaut or, you know, the small, small things that usually comes in every inquisitive kid. So I thought my dad saw a sportsman spirit in me and he thought I would be a cricketer. And I was growing up in the college and I was into dance and I thought I would be a dancer or I thought I would be a mimicry artist, something like that I would want to do. But there was something that was in me that that would like always engage me. So at the back of my school or college, I would just sit and even during my questions and my exams, I would just doodle something on my question paper, which was pretty appreciated by a lot of my friends. One of my friend, Yavanika, she saw these and she wanted me to be an illustrator in the college magazine. So I thought, yes. Then she told me about NID. I was, what is this NID? She said, National Institute of Design. So it's like people for you. So my first question was, do they have maths? And she said, no. I was like, yes, this is it. This is what I wanted to do. And I prepared myself, and this was the beginning. I dropped out after clearing my graduation, Bachelor of Business Studies. Yes, I did it. Phew. And for a year, my parents supported me. They told me that, you know, you have to be persistent and hardworking to achieve NID. Since I didn't get through at once, I was a little demotivated, and they motivated me. And I was like, yes, I can do it again. And I worked for 20 hours, and I cracked the second test. So it wasn't a big deal. But for me, it was, because I respected that place. And the cultural, the different diversity of people around the world was so much for me. It was something really new that I really wanted to learn from all of them. There were people with beautiful charcoals and mediums and everything. And I was like, I have to improve. I have to improve. I have to make something like these. So these are my old sketches. And I started sitting. I still remember with my diary, I was shivering. I was shivering like, you know, I couldn't sketch. So I started doing slowly, 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 slowly. And then I realized you have to leave your fears behind. You have to sketch it. I was scared of ruining that first page on my diary. I was scared to ruin that first canvas and the first wall. But it was just, I just dived in and then threw one ripple to another and to another. So I started doing live sketching. Live sketching really helped me out in understanding the anatomy, the lights and shadows, the perspective. This was in 2009. And after 2 years of life sketching, I made this. Then I started mixing digital and traditional artworks. Traditional mediums was more important for me. I realized this is something that has that can be merged with your soul. And also it taught me a lot of things about life. So when I came to Bangalore in 2013, there was a ripple in me. I was in a job. I was pretty happy because I was earning a lot, but something was there. I wanted to go out. I wanted to explore. During my lows in my office time, I would just go out and paint on the walls. And I would go out to the cafe, beautiful cafes that Bangalore has, and I would just sketch and meet a lot of people, meet so many new interesting artists around the world, around this whole Bangalore, that I was learning a lot from them. I learned a few techniques. I learned what to do and how to improve and not to stop yourself. So these things helped me to get my first solo art exhibition in Bangalore at Gensler. And it was on 9 feet by 9 feet canvas. So thankfully, I had been sketching Bangalore from the past 3 years, so everything got over there. And I realized, yes, because of those live sketches and the observational skills that was growing in me, made me create my another world, like the chaotic world that has. So it was a beautiful thing that I was learning at that time on the canvas. So never stop yourself learning. Never. There is no age to not to learn. And always unlearn to learn. So this got me another project. That was Coca-Cola. And I had to again build the whole canvas around India and Coca-Cola. So I was again observing India. I was traveling here and there to observe the stories to accumulate because I was out of it. So I had to inspire myself. And it took me 3 months to stitch the whole stories. And I went there and I finished coloring. So it was there at the reception. Now I wanted to spread this. I wanted to tell to other people, people like me who had started like from nowhere, people who had no backgrounds in art. So I wanted to tell everyone, it's okay. You don't have to be afraid of that empty canvas. You don't have to be afraid of that empty page. So just go ahead. What will happen? Maximum, you'll just ruin one. It's fine. You learn from it. Learn from your mistakes and go ahead. Don't stop yourself. Be persistent. So I went to Darjeeling, where I would sketch from a cafe. So the cafe owner, he came and he asked me if I want to paint a wall. I said, yes, why not? I would want to. And I would want to give it back to society. So we got permission from the municipal board. We designed something related with the whole space that was important for the culture over there. So they were impressed with my artwork. And we got the team of 20 to 25 people, the youth of Kaohsiung. The major motive was to inspire them that art is not dying. You can earn from art. And then we started. It was a good journey. It was a beautiful journey. There were a lot of people who helped us. There were shopkeepers who came up for free tea and free momos and also free gloves so that people can use it. This was a person like a barber who was inspired by us and he started decorating his own shop. So I was not stopping. I came back to Bangalore and luckily from street art I got this project about from a wall of Bal Bhavan. And I realized that this Bal Bhavan is for kids. But my wall should not be only for kids, it should also be for parents. Because I wanted to tell them that you have to be supportive. You have to understand that what are these kids liking? Are they playing with this kitchen set? Are they playing with mostly with muds and building some interesting artwork or building some interesting buildings? So just support them. Support them. Let them be free. It's okay. Whatever they're doing, it is their age. So I realized like I should leave some spaces on the wall so that people from any age group and without any art background should just come there and do whatever they want to do and remove this fear. And it turned out pretty good. I had a lot of fun interacting with so many people. And again, I got another project for Chikpet Metro Station. Now, this was a huge wall. I have vertigo. So I was a little scared. Again, the fear came and I realized, yes, again, I will face it. It's okay. So what did I do? I finished the entire coloring in 2 days by asking some college guys to help me out and we just had great fun. So I wanted to give the recognition to unrecognized since we all know Chikpet is mostly surrounded by very chaotic place and the people from all over the occupation that they do and we usually don't acknowledge them. So I wanted to put them on this huge wall. So with the help of my friends and my volunteers, my family, we painted this entire wall within one day, just the coloring basically. And we were just splattering the whole color like a kid, like how we would be when we were a kid and throwing it over there, ruining one wall. It's okay. And we went ahead. Then I started drawing it on top of it. And there were a lot of people who came and who wanted me to paint them, add them there like this kid. And it was good fun. And also, I was accompanied by my friends, families, and my dog. Then the time came when I felt like, yes, Now, this slowly, slowly, I'm achieving something. But I have to be honest that this wasn't a good sail-through journey. There were ups and downs, and there will be. It's fine. This is life. My mom and dad had always told me that never give up, and I will never. And I always wanted to achieve something, and I still don't know where I will be going. There shouldn't be any set goals, right? It's fine. Let the life take you. You meet people, you be influenced by them, you be inspired by them, but you also keep inspiring them. Just if you are scared of expressing yourself, don't be. Just let it out. Art is an outlet of emotion. You have to take care of it, whether you want to do it with words, whether you want to do it with ink, or anything. Any medium is fine. There's no hard and fast rule. But don't stop yourself in exploring yourself. It's a meditation process. It's an art. Art is a therapy. You just have to make yourself sit on one place and contemplate and just go with the flow. There were times during my breakups and my, you know, like the low phases, and I would be sitting and crying, and I realized, why am I crying? I have this beautiful thing in me, so I have to like just keep out exploring. So I would just sit and sketch, and I would be so happy. I would be so happy about that, and it changed me. And I would just go out again and meet new people. Hey, hi, hello, yeah, this is my art. I'm like, oh, wow, lovely, wow, oh. And then I'm like, yeah, I'm good, it's fine. Somebody left you, it's okay, man. Life is good. So yes, please don't stop yourself. If I can do it, anyone can do it. Thank you so much.
Those were pretty interesting.